Hi, welcome to my series of lectures on linear algebra. They will not be regular, but as and when I find time, I'll record. Today we are going to define vector spaces and perhaps look at a couple of examples. Okay, and yeah, that's it. So let us share the screen. Yes, the basic reference, of course, is my book on linear algebra, A Geometric Approach, published by PHI. I think it's a 22nd reprint or something. And it seems to be a very popular book. Okay, so it may be good that you can also have a look at that. Okay, so the basic thing is in modern mathematics, what we do is we look at some examples and try to see what are the properties which are common to all these examples and try to abstract it into a definition. Okay, in case you have seen groups definition, that's how we got it. Okay, we looked at the set of integers under addition, we looked at some other properties. Okay, we called a set with such an operation and with such properties as a group. Okay, so you should, whenever you are coming with this kind of abstract definition, do not start asking what is the use. Okay, all right, you just try to learn how to the concepts very well, then you look for applications depending upon your need and passion. You certainly find applications in almost every field of science, economics and data science, computer science, you name it, image processing, of course in mathematics too. Okay, so you have to have patience. So because this is one easy way out, it's an escape route to ask what is the use. Okay, please bear with us, learn it. Then you look for, okay, then you will find depending upon your interest. Because if I say some application, you may not be interested in it. Okay, so it is up to you to find out. Okay? So have an open mind, because when you learned something the earlier days also, that's how you did. Okay, you did not know what, did you ask what is the use of trying to write? I already know how to speak and communicate. You started learning something, then you found out, okay, at people who are at a different place, you can still communicate your ideas through writing. You see that? So you have to learn. Okay, let us, after this philosophy, let me start. So let us look at R, the set of real numbers. Okay, and we can also look at this Q, set of rational numbers, or C, the set of complex numbers. Okay, or if you know what is meant by field, a field, R, Q, C are examples of a field. Okay, they all have some properties common. Okay, we want to extract. So let me simply call F. If you are uncomfortable, you can always assume it's R, RQ, or a C. Okay. Then I want to know to write Fn. Fn is Cartesian product of F cross F n times. Okay. This is set of all X, okay, equal to X1 to Xn. This is the n tuples. So that, where are Xi? Xi is R in F. And 1 less than or equal to I, less than or equal to N. Okay, later I may even find a reason to write this X as a column. This is a row, I may also want it to write it as a column. Okay, you follow that? Okay, now notice that, since, as I said, let me stick to R. Okay, you can substitute F in place of R. Okay, and almost everywhere, no problem. Now we notice that in R we have certain natural operations, namely addition, that carries over to Rn. How does it carry over to? And again, let me notice that I'm on x. I don't want to write it as this way. X as a vector, or x as a bold face, or underline, nothing of that kind. I'll simply write x, and I will write it x1 to xn. The context must make it clear. If I write x equal to Rn, then you should know x is an n tuple of real numbers. Okay. So do not say that I should write it like this, or I should write like this, or if there is a bold face available, I should write it like that, x. Okay. We will simply write it xx. Now suppose you give me x and y, two such n tuples, we will call elements of Rn as vectors. Okay, these are called vectors. Again, please do not get confused with this vectors you are learning physics, Rn vector. Okay, because they are something like different. They are vectors based at some point to some point. This is x to y, that kind of thing. This is not the same x and y. Okay, this is just, okay, erase it from your memory what you learned about physics. It will come later if necessary. But for us, any element of Rn by definition is a vector. You should not think of this vector in the sense of physics. Even though it can be made sense, but that's not our aim now. Okay, right. Now, I want to say I can define an addition. On Rn, I can define an addition. This is same as saying it's a binary map from Rn to Rn. Okay, a map. This map is called a binary operation. Any map from Rn cross Rn to Rn is called a binary operation on Rn. So you give me two vectors x and y. X is an n tuple in Rn, y is an n tuple in Rn. Then I have to get an n tuple in Rn. You understand? So what I do is, since x equal to x1 to xn, y equal to y1 to yn, I'm going to define it to be the n tuple x1 plus y1, x2 plus y2, xn plus yn, dot, 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 xn plus yn. You understand? Where x equal to x1 to xn, y equal to y1 to yn. How is that possible? Because x1 and y1 are real numbers, therefore I know how to add. Similarly for x2, y2, xn, yn. You understand that? And this is a real number, and this is an ordered n tuple. Therefore, I have defined an addition. Okay? Right. Now notice that, so I will denote this map, this goes to, it's not equal to, this goes to, this I denote by x plus y. Therefore, I define x plus y, that is x is a vector in Rn, n tuple in Rn, y is an n tuple in Rn, x plus y, notice that we are defining. Okay, how do you define? In terms of the components. When x equal to x2 to x1 to xn, we call xi as ith component, or ith coordinate of the vector x. Okay, so I define x plus y in terms of the component wise or coordinate wise addition, that is the n tuple x1 plus y1, comma, xn plus yn. This is our definition. This simple, okay, colon equal to, this means the left side is defined by the right side. X plus y is defined as the n tuple x1 plus y1, xn plus yn. This is one. Do you understand this? Okay. Now notice that the very first thing you can notice is something very interesting. If I take y and x, see, notice that this is x comma y is an ordered pair of vectors. Then I can also take the ordered pair yx. Y is an Rn, x is also an Rn. Then under this map, it will go to y plus x. Do you understand this? Now what is y plus x? Y plus x is y1, the first coordinate of y, plus the first coordinate of x, which is y1 plus x1, comma yn plus xn. Now comes the next thing. I want to say these two vectors are equal. What do I mean by that? So we should start with defining in Rn itself. So suppose, just because I used x and y, suppose u is a vector, v is a vector in Rn, and I say u, suppose u equal to u1 to un, and v equal to v1 to vn, then when do I say u equal to v? I say u equal to v if and only if, for all I, ui must be equal to vi. That is, ith coordinate of u must be equal to ith coordinate of v. Do you understand this? Very good. So this is our definition of equality of two vectors in Rn. Now let us look at x plus y. I have defined as a vector whose ith coordinate is xi plus yi. Y plus x is a vector whose ith coordinate is yi plus xi. Now I want to know whether these two vectors are the same. How do I know that? If the ith coordinates are the same for each and every I, the ith coordinate of x plus y is xi plus yi, ith coordinate of y plus x is yi plus xi. But remember, xi, yi are real numbers. So xi plus yi is same as yi plus xi. Those real numbers are the same. Therefore, I have shown x plus y is same as y plus x. Do you understand this? Okay. Therefore, we conclude x plus y is same as y plus x. So pause, review, and proceed. PRP. Okay. Now, there is also another thing. Suppose I have three vectors x, y, z ordered a triple in Rn cross Rn cross Rn. Right? Notice that our addition adds only two vectors at a time. But I have three vectors. I want to see whether I can add them. Now, what are the ways I can add? Remember, when I want to add, it should be ordered pair. Therefore, I can take it. Just let us see that. X plus y and add, okay, I will get x plus y. Then add x plus y and z. You understand that? Therefore, first I will have x, y, that will go to x plus y. Then that will go to, this is a vector x plus y plus z. Do you understand? Or I can do in a slightly different way. X, y, z. Now what I do is, I need an ordered pair, right? I cannot take x, z. The correct order is y, z. Therefore, what will I do? I will do y, z. Okay, that go to y plus z. But then x is at the front. Therefore, x, that will go to x, y, z. That is x plus y plus z. Okay. If it's slightly confusing, don't worry, you will get used to this kind of thing. Okay, you know how to do in real numbers, we are doing it. See, if I take 4 plus 5 and then add 3, or I do 5 plus 3 and add 4, there the answers are the same. That's what we are trying to say. Okay, right. You follow that? So what do I want now? So I want x plus y plus z should be same as x plus y plus z for any ordered triple of vectors in Rn cross Rn cross Rn. Okay. Usually in textbooks we'll write for every vector x, y, z, x plus y and add it to z should be same as add x to y plus z. Okay, this is what you call associativity of the addition. The earlier one you call it as a commutativity. Addition is commutative. Here I have seen addition is, notice that the commutativity of the addition of vectors actually follows from the commutativity of the addition of real numbers. And similarly, associativity, I have to prove, let us prove it. After that, I will see. Okay. Now, what is x plus y? That is going to be x1 plus y1, xn plus yn, plus z, z1, zn. When I add, what will I get? I will get x1 plus y1 plus z1. This is the first coordinate. And what is the nth coordinate? Xn plus yn plus zn. You understand? This is x plus y plus z. Right? Now, let us look at x plus y plus z. This is x1 to xn plus y plus z I have to add. That is, what is the first coordinate? Y1 plus z1. What is the nth coordinate? Yn plus zn. Now, x1, x2, xn is a vector. Y1 plus z1, comma, yn plus zn is a vector. How do I add them? I have to add them coordinate wise. That means x1 plus y1 plus z1. This is the first coordinate. What is the nth coordinate? Xn plus yn plus zn. Right? Now I want to say these two vectors are equal. X plus y plus z is same as x plus y plus z. Okay? That, when are these two equal? If and only the ith coordinate of the first vector should be equal to the corresponding ith coordinate of the second vector. What is the ith coordinate of the first vector? It is xi plus yi plus zi. What is the ith coordinate of the second vector? That is xi plus yi plus zi. Now, are they equal? Yes. Why? Because of associativity of real numbers. Do you understand that? Yeah. So, associativity, that is x plus y plus z is same as x plus y plus z. This associativity of the vectors actually is follows from the associativity of the addition of real numbers. Yeah. Please pause, review, and proceed. If this is the first time you are going through this, you are a second year BSc student, you should please spend time. Okay. Don't rush through. Okay, now there is a third property. Let us look at theta to be this vector whose all the coordinates are 0, 0, 0. This is Norn. Right? Now, this vector, I call it theta. Later, I will denote only by 0. Okay? Whether 0 stands for the vector in Norn or 0 stands for the real number 0, the context should make it clear. Okay? See, all of us should get used to this kind of thing. See, mass is deals with symbols, right? So you should learn to work with such things, right? Suppose I look at two real numbers a comma b, suppose integers, okay, 3 and okay 15. Now if I write this ordered pair, I can think of this an ordered pair in R cross R, or if I think of this as a subset of real numbers, this is an open interval, a subset of R. If you are in number theory, this stands for GCD of 3 and 15. Right? The ordered pair 3, 15 has already three different meanings. If you are in number theory, the moment you see ordered pair 3, 15, you will think it's a GCD. If you are in real analysis, the moment you see this ordered pair 3, 15, you don't think of it as ordered pair, you will think of an open interval in R. Okay? When I think of this 315 in R cross R, then I will think of it as an ordered pair of real numbers. That's an element of R2. You see that? So context should make it clear. Okay. Right? So anyway, come back. So I have this vector. What is the speciality of this vector? Start with any vector x in Rn. What do you think x plus theta is? X plus theta by definition is x1 plus 0, xn plus 0. But that is same as x1, xn, but that is same as x. Therefore, for any vector x in Rn, x plus theta is x. And similarly, theta plus x is x. Because it will be 0 plus x1, 0 plus xn, that is x1, x2, xn. You understand? So, there is some interesting vector. This vector, we will call it a 0 vector. Okay, theta is called the 0 vector. Now there is a fourth property. Fourth property is, you give me any x, okay? Let x be in Rn. I say there exists a vector y in Rn, okay, so that x plus y is theta, the zero vector. You understand? In real number, what do I have? If a is a real number, then there is a real number b, so that a plus b is zero. This b, I denote it by minus a. You see that? It's a notation. Minus a stands for the element real number b, so that a plus b is zero. Okay. Now, so given any x, I want to say there is a y, so that x plus y is the zero vector theta. How will I find that? Okay. I can immediately supply, don't say minus y. Okay. Minus y do not know what it means. I know y, but minus y has no meaning at present. You follow that? Okay. So you cannot say it's minus x because of your high school's kind of thing. So we have to go slowly. It should be a vector. Okay. I can write down the vector and verify, but instead we will find out what the vector y is. Okay. Suppose there is a vector y, so that x plus y is theta. What is x plus y then? X plus y is x1 plus y1 plus xn plus yn. Okay. Now y is, said that x plus y is zero. That means this vector must be theta. That means it's same as 0, 0, 0. So when this vector and this vector are equal, they are equal if only yth coordinates of the vectors must be the same. That means for all I, xi plus yi must be equal to zero. So what is xi then? See, x is given, y is unknown. I have to find this y. To find y, I have to find y1, y2, yn. So this gives me what should be my yi. What is my yi? This yi is minus xi. You see that? Given any real number a, there is a real number b, so that a plus b is zero, this b is unique. That b is what I denote by minus a. Therefore, this y I is nothing other than minus xi. Do you understand this? Therefore, what is the y? Y is minus x1, minus x2, minus xn. Okay. So I found this y. Now you can verify y, x plus y is theta and same as y plus x. Have you understood? So P, R, So far now we have seen four properties. All of them deal with addition. Okay, let me just write it, summarize. So I have a map addition. I call it addition as vector addition. It's a map from Rn cross Rn to R. What does it do? Give me any two vectors x and y ordered pair in Rn. It goes to x plus y. This we have defined, okay? And this map has satisfied the following properties. What are the following properties? For every xy in Rn, x plus y is same as y plus x. This is what we call as commutativity. And two, I will write it as a standard way for every vector xyz in Rn, but remember this is an ordered triple, okay? X plus y plus z is same as x plus y plus z. Okay. Three, there is a vector called theta or zero vector in Rn, so that for all x in Rn, what do I have? X plus theta is same as x, which is same as theta plus x, zero plus x. And there is a fourth property. What is the fourth property? Says, give me any x in Rn. Notice the quantifiers. They change the way. Okay. There exists a y in Rn such that x plus y is theta, which is y plus x. These are the four properties you have checked so far. Okay. Please go through, make sure you understand. Now, let me call this A1, A2, A4. Okay, I'll call these properties as A1, A2, A3, and A4. A4 addition. Okay, now there is another interesting thing I can do that. Suppose you give me a real number T in R and a vector x equal to x1 to xn in Rn, I can define a new vector in Rn. How do I define? Let's look at Tx1, Txn. What is Tx1? Remember, T is a real number, x1 is a real number. Therefore, it is a product of two real numbers, T and x1. Similarly, T into xn. Do you understand? This is a new vector in Rn, right? This vector we denote by T dot x or Tx. Notice that this is a number, T is a number, x is a vector. So I am defining something like a product. I am just using a dot symbol, but later we will simply write it as Tx. It's just a notation again, as usual. Mathematics thrives with notations with proper understanding. That's why the concepts are more important. Okay. Some other person may want to use some other symbol also for this vector. Okay. But that does not matter, but the concept should be the same. So the new vector t dot x is a vector whose n tuple is tx1, tx2, txn. The ith coordinate of the vector tx is t times xi. It's, you follow that? Yes. Okay. What will be 1 if t equal to 1? What will be 1 dot x? It is 1x1, 1xn. Therefore, it's same as x1 x xn, which is same as x. Right? Is it clear? And what is t equal to 0? What is 0 dot x? That will be 0x1, 0x2, 0xn. Therefore, it is the 0 theta, the 0 vector theta. Yeah, this is just observation so that you get used to this notation. Okay, therefore, what kind of a map I have? It's always good to define these kind of operations by certain maps. So what I have is, I have R and I have Rn, take the Cartesian product. Then I have a map R cross Rn to Rn. What is the map? Give me a real number T, give me a vector X in Rn. I get a new vector in Rn, which is, I denote, this is a notation. Again, please remember, this is just a notation. Okay, this is t dot x. This I call as scalar multiplication. This map is what I call scalar multiplication. And tx, I say, is a scalar multiple of the vector x. And what is the scalar? The t I call as a scalar. So this t is called a scalar. And this is called a scalar multiple of which vector? Of the vector x. By the scalar, scalar multiple, which scalar? By the scalar t. Okay. Please try to repeat this kind of thing. Okay. So that you will become more familiar. This is the way to internalize new concepts. You just don't assume, just to try to say it in your own words so that you become more and more comfortable. Okay. Now what I want to do is, like earlier, I saw addition has four properties. So I want to say this so-called scalar multiplication has also four properties. Do you follow that? Okay. So what are the four properties? Okay. Let us go one by one. So let us call S1. Okay. Now notice that if I give a scalar t in R, suppose you give me two vectors x and y in Rn, then I know what is meant by x plus y. That is the vector addition of these two vectors x and y, right? Therefore, I can multiply this, scalar multiply this vector x plus y by the vector t. Okay, where does this go to? T times x plus y. Notice that this right side is just a symbol. Okay, x plus y is some kind of vector z. Okay, z1 to zn. And what is zi? zeta is xi plus yi. Ith coordinate is this. Okay. And therefore, what is t times that? That is tz1, tz2. Do you understand this? Okay. Now, let's try to understand what happens to this. Okay. What is t dot x plus y? Now, what is t dot x plus y? As usual, x is x1 to xn, y is y1 plus yn. Therefore, t dot x1 plus y1, xn plus yn. But this is just a notation. But what it stands for a vector. What is the vector it stands for? It stands for the vector t into x1 plus y1, because t multiplies each of the coordinates, right? Tx1, Txn. Therefore, t times x1 plus yn dot dot t times xn plus yn. You understand? But now notice that we know that the multiplication of a real number is distributes over the addition of real numbers. That is a times b plus c, a the multiplication by a distributes over the sum. What do I get? I get a b plus a c. Therefore, I can use it here. T x1 plus y1 is t x1 plus t y1 and t x n plus t y n. Do you understand this? Yeah. Now I can do something very interesting. What will I do is I will collect the x square things, tx1, tx2 and txn, and I will separately collect ty1, tyn. Do you understand? So I can write it as the n tuple tx1, txn, okay, right, plus ty1, tyn. Do you understand this? I'm collecting tx1, the first from the first coordinate. Second coordinate, I will collect tx2. The nth coordinate, I will collect txn. That I get an ordered n tuple. That I call it tx1, tx2, txn. And similarly, in the first coordinate, t of x1 plus ty1, I collect the second term, ty1. In the second term, it will be ty2. In the nth term, tyn. Now I have an ordered n tuple. Namely, ty1 to tyn. You understand this? Right. But what is tx1, txn? By our definition of scalar multiplication, this is t times x1 to xn. And similarly, the second term is t times y1 to yn. But this is nothing other than t dot x plus t dot y. Do you understand this? Yeah. So what have you shown? Something very interesting. As we have distributive law for real numbers, a times b plus c is a b plus a c, we have in some sense a distributive law. But okay, do not say that this is distributive law, because your algebra teacher will be angry. That's not a correct way. But as a mnemonic, mnemonic is the English word to say it's a kind of aid to memory. Aid to memory. It just makes it easy to remember. Okay, as a mnemonic, I think of this as a scalar multiplication distributes over vector addition. Do you understand this? Scalar multiplication distributes over vector addition. Look at what I am doing. Is it clear? So that is property number S1 for me. Namely, for all x and y in Rn, t dot x plus y is same as t dot x plus t dot y. What is the mnemonic? T, the scalar multiplication, distributes over vector addition. Okay. Right? Okay. Now, there is another thing which is equally important. I could see that. What is the next one? Next one is S2. Now suppose S and T are real numbers and X is a vector in Rn. Now S and T are real numbers, therefore I can add S plus T. Right? This is a real number. Therefore this real number can scalar multiply this vector X. Okay, go slow. Okay. You understand? S plus T is a number. call it if you want u or r. This real number r dot x makes sense. You understand? How is it defined? As usual, x will be x1, x2, xn. So I'm not going to say every time. So this is by definition s plus t into x1. And what is the nth coordinate? The scalar s plus t into nth coordinate of x, namely xn. Do you understand this? This is by definition. But now s, t, x1, these are all real numbers. Therefore, s plus t into x1 is distributive law of multiplication over addition. Therefore, this is same as s x1 plus t x1. And what is the second one? S plus t into x2, that is s x2 plus t x2. What is the last one? S xn plus t xn. Now you should know the game. What do you think I will do? What are the things I will collect? I want an n-tuple. I want another n-tuple. I am going to say this n-tuple, okay, is sum of two obvious n-tuples. Can you guess? As we did in the last thing, you should be able to make a guess. So you should be part of the game. Then only you will begin to appreciate, you will find it easier. What should it be? Yes, I will collect everything with respect to S now. Because there are, X is fixed. There earlier, X and Y are there. I collected something through the X1, X2, Xn, Y1, Y2, Yn. Do you understand this? I collected X1, X2, Xn, and the letter Y1, Y2, Yn. Here, X is fixed. Therefore, Xn, T are varying. Therefore, what should I do? Yes, very good. So I should collect yes, yes, and yes. And next I should collect T, T, and T. What does it mean? It means this. I collected S, X1, S, X2, S, Xn plus T, X1, T, X2, T, Xn. Do you understand this? If I add these two vectors, what will I get? S, X1 plus T, X1. I got it. And S, X2 plus T, X2. I got it. And S, Xn plus T, Xn. I got it. You understand that? Okay. Now it's very easy. What is S, X1, S, X2, S, Xn? Now you'll cut it short. It is S dot X1, X2, Xn. That is same as S dot X. And similarly, this is T dot X. So what I have shown? S plus T dot X. You understand this? So this is also some kind of distributive law, but I cannot say the earlier way. Okay. Now what does it do? Okay. Do you see that? Please understand. This also looks like a distributive law, but then here it is addition. This is not, I can't say multiplication. Okay. The vector is not multiplying over the vector, the scalar addition. You follow that? But in some sense, it's a distributive law. Okay. But please, please do not use the word distributivity in front of your teacher. Nobody will like it. Especially algebra teachers will not like it. Okay. You are followed? Now, can somebody guess what should be S3? Look at that. In Rn, I have only vector addition. I did that. Okay. In scalars, I have vector scalar addition. That is addition of real numbers. I did that. What is the next one I should investigate? See, S and T are real numbers. In real numbers, I can also multiply them out. You understand that? So what should I do? I should try to see. Let S and T be real numbers. And X again be a vector in Rn, then S times T is a real number, new real number R. Therefore, I can ask what is R dot X, which is S T dot X. Do you understand? Right? Okay. Now let us do that. What is S T dot X? According to our definition, S T, the scalar must multiply the first coordinate X1. S T into X1. Second coordinate will be ST into X2. Nth coordinate will be ST into XN. Do you understand this? Right. Now let's look at the first coordinate. What is that? S is serial number, T is serial number, X1 is serial number. Therefore, it is ST times X1. And second thing is also ST, the real number times X2 and so on. So you are multiplying three real numbers. So again, let us look at a general case. Suppose A, B, C are real numbers. Then I can multiply A, B first. And this is the real number. I can multiply it by C. Or I can multiply B, C first and multiply it by A. We know that these are equal. You follow that? Therefore, I can write this as S T into X1. I can write as S into T X1. And similarly, S into T X2. And S into T X N. Do you understand? Right. Now something very interesting happens. See, now this S is a common thing. Okay. And let us look at TX1, TX2, TXN. That is an n tuple of real numbers in Rn. Therefore, it's a vector. And I am multiplying each of the ith coordinate by S. Therefore, this is nothing other than S dot the vector TX1, TXN. Do you follow that? Yeah. But what is TX1, TXN? That is scalar multiplying the vector x1, x2, xn by the scalar t. Therefore, it is s dot t dot x. Okay. Do not be in a hurry. If you are a beginner, especially second year BC student, just now you stepped in. Okay. It takes time to get used to that. Okay. Please pause the video and review every time. And best is, discuss with your friends. You follow that? Notice that what we do, st dot x. Now st is a real number, x is a vector. Here s dot t dot x. Okay. Now it looks almost like associative. Did you see that? A dot bc is same as ab dot c. Okay. So it's something like associativity. Again, it's a mnemonic. Okay. Don't say this is associativity in front of your algebra teacher. Okay. For any teacher for that matter. It's not a correct way of saying. But as a mnemonic, it helps me to do that. Okay. So what I have shown, for any two real numbers ST, take the product of these real numbers and take the scalar multiple of X with respect to the product. This is same as do it with T, scalar multiple of T, then do it with S. These are the same. This is your S3. And S4 is what we had already seen. What is a special real number? Namely 1 and 0. These are the two special real numbers. So S4 deals with only one of them. Okay. So take T equal to 1 and X to be in R. Then what is 1 dot X? It is X. This is true for all X. For X in R. Yeah. Right. So the scalar multiplication R cross Rn to Rn. Okay. Namely Tx going to T dot X has four properties. What are the four properties? S1 is, I don't remember, but I hope I will write it. T of X plus Y is T dot X plus T dot Y. And what is S2? S plus T dot X is S dot X plus T dot X. What is S3? S3 is like associative. Do you see that? That's how I remember. S T dot X is S dot T dot X. See, T dot X is a vector. Therefore, I can multiply this vector by a scalar. Yes. Therefore, I get S dot T dot X. But what is that? I could have done it in what? One step. Multiply S and T, get a real number ST and multiply scalar multiply the vector X by the real, these two are the same. Yeah, if you want, let me write it. Okay, now S4 is 1 dot X equal to X. Okay, look at the three. It may be a good idea to do in a slightly different way. Okay, so I have X, I multiply it, scalar multiply with this T dot X. Then I scalar multiply this by S. I get S dot T dot X. You understand? Or I can multiply this AX by ST, the real number ST, so dot X. What we are saying, these are equal. Okay, good. So what we have seen therefore is in Rn, okay, we have what is called a vector addition. That is a map from Rn cross Rn to Rn with some special property. Okay, it has properties A1 to A4. And we have what we call dot is a scalar multiplication. That is a map from R cross Rn to Rn with S1 to S4. You understand this? So on Rn we have two operations. One is Rn cross Rn to Rn, which is vector addition. Another one is R cross Rn to Rn, which is called scalar multiplication. So this we call is a vector space. Okay. So please go through, pause, review, proceed. Okay. So what you have shown on Rn, what is Rn? Yeah, ordered n tuple of real numbers. Then we define, give me any n tuple x1, x2, xn, y1, y2, yn, then I know how to add. Then we saw there are four properties. And next, given any real number t and an ordered n tuple of real numbers x1 to xn, then I know what is, I can produce a new vector. Okay, new n tuple, ordered n tuple. What is it? Tx1, Tx2, Txn. That I call t dot x. We understood these two operations have each one of them have four properties. We listed them. Okay. Now what we want to do is we want to make an abstraction of this. Okay. Before that, let us see that we have seen such a thing in a context of linear equations. Okay. I will do that. And if time permits, I will define a vector space also. Otherwise, in the next lecture. See, suppose you have a system, homogeneous system of, okay, homogeneous system of m linear equations in n variables. Okay, how will you write it? A11 x1 plus A1n xn equal to 0, and ith equation will be AI1 x1 plus AIn xn equal to 0. Last equation will be AMn x1 plus AMn xn equal to 0. In shorthand notation, we denote it by Aij, Xj. J is running from 1 to n equal to 0, but I also varies. I runs from 1 to m. Therefore, this is a homogeneous system. Now, let C1 to Cn, let us assume all these are all the scalars A11, Aij, general is Aij. These are all real numbers. When do I say, what do I mean by a solution of this homogeneous system? That means I have an ordered n tuple C1, C2, Cn of real numbers. C1, C2, Cn in Rn. It's ordered n tuple. It's not just like that. There exists C1 to C2, Cn. Notice that the order is also important there. So that in place of Xj, I substitute Cj, then this must be equal. That means what? This is a solution of, let us say this is a homogeneous system, solution of the homogeneous system H, if Aij, Cj, j running from 1 to n, must be 0. This must be true for every equation. You understand? Yeah? Right. Yes, therefore a solution, okay? So let SH be the set of all solutions. So what does it mean? C1 to Cn, this must be an n tuple in Rn. And with what property? I will simply call it C. C is a solution of the homogeneous system H. Understood? And this set is non-empty. Why? Our theta always is in SH. Because I substitute Aij, Cj equal to 0. Therefore, this will always be 0. Therefore, this SH is not empty. Right? Now, what you must have seen, if you have not seen, do it. Suppose C equal to C1 to Cn and D equal to D1 to Dn. And suppose these are solutions of the homogeneous system. Right? Then I can construct a new solution. Okay? What is the new solution? This is our C plus D, namely C1 plus D1 plus Cn plus Dn. This is also a solution of the homogeneous system. This is, you must have checked it, or it's very easy to check, because Aij into Cj plus Dj, use the distributivity Aij into Cj plus Aij into Dj, and now separate them out, you'll have 0 plus 0. Okay? And similarly, you've seen, if T is a scalar, I can construct this Tc1, Tcn, this is also a solution of homogeneous system. Right? Therefore, what have we shown now? SH also shows a similar property. SH to SH, I have a vector addition. Notice that I take two solutions, their addition is again, their sum, vector sum is again a solution. It's not some arbitrary, a vector in Rn. Okay, it's a vector, but it's also a solution of the homogeneous system. And I also have R cross SH to SH. Right? Scalar multiple of a homogeneous. So scalar multiple of a solution of the homogeneous system is again a solution of the homogeneous system. Okay? It's exactly similar to what we did in case of Rn. And whereas SH may be a proper subset of Rn. Right? It may not be all of Rn. For example, take only m equal to 1 and n equal to 2, this is R2. R2, right? What is the solution set? Solution set is Rx minus y equal to 0. The solution set is all x cross x as x varies over R. So this is a subset of R2. You can geometrically think of it as this line y equal to x line. Yeah, this is the solution set SH. Right. So let me stop the lecture by defining a vector space so that it will also give you a time or thing. So let V be a some set. Teachers usually will say it's a non-empty set, but that's not needed. You will see why it's not needed. Okay. And suppose there exists a map plus V cross B to V. This is like Rn, Rn cross Rn to Rn, or SH cross SH to SH. Okay. You give me two elements of V, I will call as a vectors. I don't know what is V. Okay, but elements will be called as vectors. Okay, give me two element ordered pair x, y, x is in V, y is also in V. Then the image, this is a function. Remember, this plus is a function. Okay, if you want, let me call it P plus, okay? P of x, y. Okay, this must be a vector in, this must be an element of V. This element, I will denote this just a notation. By x plus y. X plus y is a notation for the image of the ordered pair xy under the map P. Okay. And y. So we will simply denote by x plus y. That is, given any xy, xy goes to x plus y. That's it. That is v cross v to v. Okay. Then this has the four properties A1 to A4. What are the four properties? x plus y is same as y plus x for which x and y? For all x and y in V. And next, take x, y, z. You add y and z first and then add x, or add x and y first and then add z. All should be equal. These two must be equal. This is a1, it is a2. What is a3? There exists a unique vector theta in V. There is a vector theta in V so that x plus theta equal to theta plus x must be equal to x. This is true for every x in V. Okay. And what is the last one? Give me an x in V. There is a y in V so that x plus y must be theta. Notice that what we are doing in the earlier case, we exhibited the theta. Here we are saying that there should be a vector, an element denoted by theta with the property a3. What is the property? We are demanding it. In the case of Rn or in the case of sh, we know what theta is. Here we don't know. Okay. On V, we have the so-called vector addition, the map plus. Okay, this map has the following property. X plus y must be y plus x. X plus y plus z must be x plus y plus z. And next, there is a vector theta so that x plus theta must be equal to theta plus x. Okay. And the last one is, so give me any x in V, I should be able to find another element y. So when I add them x plus y, the vector addition of x plus y must be this vector theta which you gave me by a3. Okay, do you follow? Okay, we are demanding these things. Okay, it should happen. And next, we want to say there also exists a scalar multiplication S from R cross V to R. Okay, that is S T X. We denote it by T dot X. This is just a notation. X S is a map from R cross V to V. So that the image of the ordered pair Tx under S is denoted by T dot X. And what do I want? This S must satisfy the four properties S1 to S4. Okay, what is it? Yes, S plus T times X must be Sx plus Tx. Do you understand this? We are demanding it should happen. And similarly, S into X plus Y must be equal to S dot X plus S dot Y. The next one is S T dot X must be equal to S dot T dot X. Last one is 1 dot X equal to X. These are all true for every X1 Y, XY in V, S T in R, etc. The most important thing for a beginner to understand is that with V, I am able to find what is known as vector addition. It's actually a map, okay, from V cross V to V, satisfying those four properties. Then I have another map called scalar multiplication, which is a map from R cross V to V, which satisfies the four properties of S1 to S4. This satisfies A1 to A4. You understood that? These are all given. This we will denote by only by dot now. This S we will denote by dot. Because S of Tx, we are going to denote by T dot X. So I will denote by this. And similarly, P of xy, I am going to write as X plus Y. So I denote by Y. So now notice that V is necessarily non-empty. Because I said there exists a theta in V. So that something happens. You understand? Therefore, there is no need for me to say V is non-empty in the beginning. Okay, come back. So, the set V with a vector addition and with a scalar multiplication is called a vector space over R. Okay. You follow that? We will look at the examples in the next lecture. because an hour and I spent considerable time, because this lecture is aimed at beginning students of BSc. So I wanted to go slow so that you feel comfortable. Please pause, review, proceed, go through it at least once or twice, discuss with your friends and report your book, my book or any other book on energy block will have something similar. Okay. So we'll meet again. Have a good day.